So one of the primary challenges in working with first responders is the idea that they have anything wrong at all. First responders are strong and they're tough and they're resilient. And so when you talk to them about having a post-traumatic stress issue, to them that sounds like a sign of weakness. But what we need to understand is living a life under stress creates changes in the brain over time. There becomes a hypervigilance, almost a suspiciousness, that creates walls and distance between the person and their family when they go home. The next thing you know, they're 15 degrees off from where they used to be. And yet at the same time, it feels to them like it's just the job. Hi, I'm Dr. Stephen Odom. I'm the founder and chief clinical officer of First Responder Wellness. There are several components that make First Responder Wellness special. First and foremost is the idea that we have cultural competency. What does that really mean? That means that we're a team of professionals who not only know what we're doing in the world of behavioral health and addiction treatment, but we have experience both personally and professionally as first responders or having worked in the healthcare population. We provide a holistic approach to treatment where we understand that everything we do is trauma-based, but at the same time, we understand that there are other factors intervening in making lives difficult for first responders and their families. Whether it's the fact that they have to go on all those bad calls, whether it's the fact that they're trying to save the world one person at a time. Gradually over the course of a career, it becomes too much. And without any tools and without an understanding of what resiliency really is and how to build it, the stress accumulates, builds up as stress chemicals in the brain. They get into dissociative behaviors, self-medication, they get distant in their relationships. And the next thing you know, the wheels are coming off their own personal bus. Here at First Responder Wellness, we understand that, and we also have a deep respect for the job that they do, and know that these people can heal and can get better again.